Hey guys, today I'm going to show you some of these Tillotson clone carburetors. Now, before we couldn't get an accurate measurement of the throttle bore, and I'm going to try to do one today. I had to remove this choke assembly from this thing so I can get this ID gauge in there. And I bought a set of these things. These are those long reach ID measuring tools. You can get these off of the jungle site for, you know, less than 20 bucks. It's just a little spring loaded tool. Kind of clamp it down there and run that inside the bore of whatever you're measuring and then kind of release the spring. I need three hands to do this, so bear with me. I'm trying to get it about right down in the center of that Venturi. And then once I do, I'm going to release the spring-loaded clip there. Try to get it to the largest area I can. Then I'm going to lock it down. Now, see if I can verify that this is going fitting right. And these Venturi, some of them have a little flashing on them, so that's going to hang me up a little bit. I'm gonna try to turn it where I can get off of that, but you know, this is, I'm probably gonna be off a thousandth or two, maybe more, so this is just gonna be a rough estimate. Can't get exact because of the flashing and the bore. But now this is the FULIN brand carburetor, and as it turns out, it's got a Venturi size of right at 750 thousandths. So you're looking right at 3/4 of an inch for the Venturi size. And that's perfectly respectable. That would be a good improvement over a stock 212 carburetor. Just the little FULIN, F-U-L-I-N brand. And that was the first one I received. And, you know, it was a great looking little carburetor. So I went ahead and ordered another one, and I've ordered some more since then. I mean, the next one they sent me was this Tillotson branded, or at least it's got Tillotson branded blocks on it. The block stack says Tillotson, made in Ireland. And the Venturi, now this is a different one, but this is the same carb that I used on the Ducar 212 engine build. And the Venturi on this one looked a little bit larger than the FULIN, but not much. The other carb that I put on the 212, I think, had a larger Venturi than what this one does. But this one measures out. Let me get it up here. And again, keep in mind, this is maybe off of a few thousandth one way or another. So I'm getting around 785 thousandths on the ID bore size of the Venturi. 785 thousandths. Now that's very respectable, and nothing wrong with that. But you know, I think the other one actually had a larger bore. I believe it did. Now this is a different one. I hadn't showed you guys these. Oh, yeah, this is the Tillotson. Yeah, you've seen this one. 785 thousandths. I bet it was supposed to be a copy of a 787 thousandths bore. But good looking Venturi in that thing. Good looking carburetor. I'm tickled to death with them. This is the one that I haven't showed you yet. Now this is another one I bought. This one's supposed to be for a Harley Davidson golf cart replacement carburetor. And it's not branded. I can't find a name, a number, anything on it anywhere. And I think I paid, you know, right at 20 bucks, a little less than 20 bucks for this one. And it's kind of weird. It's got the throttle is spring loaded to where it stays open. So that's kind of strange. I mean, I've never owned a Harley Davidson golf cart before, guys, so I'm not sure how that would work. But yeah, it looks like the Venturi on the Harley replacement carb is bigger. So matter of fact, I think the Venturi on the Harley carb is about the same size as the one I used on the Ducar Tillotson. Well, this is a strange carburetor. And that might be normal for Harleys. You know, I'm not a golfing guy, so I never really had a golf cart, so. Oh, yeah. And this one, I'm going to have to get this choke. I think I tried to remove the choke out of that thing, and it's got one screw that doesn't want to cooperate. So I'm going to pull the throttle shaft out of it and butterfly and see if I can get something in there. It's just not going to go without it, without removing that. Be right back. And there we go. And once you get your screw out of the butterfly, that's for the throttle shaft, just grab it with a pair of needle nose and give her a little tug and yeah, it should just pop right out. And once that's out of there, that just slides right out. Yeah, I'm not sure that spring mechanism is actually set up there right, because that, you know, the way it was starting, it would have started wide open. That's kind of strange. I don't know, maybe that's normal on a Harley cart. And I'm going to go ahead and use a plastic bag from the small parts, because, you know, you guys know, if I don't, I'll lose them. Now, same deal. Kind of close the little spring-loaded long-reach ID measuring tool, then unlock it and let the tips spring out inside the Venturi there. And once I get it to the widest point, I'm going to lock it down and then double check it by moving it in and out of the Venturi for a little bit. Make sure I get a little drag on there. And let's see, did it feel okay? That's probably about as close as I'll get it. And let's see what we got on this one. Oh, let's see. 865 thousandths. Wow. Now that's a good size Venturi. 865 thousandths. And it may be off of my measurement, may be off a few thousandths one way or another, guys. Just keep that in mind, because these do have a lot of flashing casting on the casting of the Venturi. But that would be a nice carburetor body to build. This is kind of strange. It's got a extended low screw, which that's normal. I've seen those on the Tillotson carburetors they set up for carts. That's kind of commonplace. But now this high speed, and I had loosened this, it's got a plug here. Inside is a removable jet. Now that's a new one on me. I have not seen one of these Tillotsons. Of course, you know, like I said, guys, I've not worked on the Harley Davidson golf carts, but that's new to me. I've never seen that done on the Tillotson. Now this is one of those little cheap import intakes you can buy, and they're usually, you know, sometimes you can get them with a kit that gets like a VDM 22 or one of these PZ 27s or something carburetors, and that's normally what those are for. And the intake that you would normally use with these Tillotsons is about $50. I mean, unless you make your own, the billet intake is kind of expensive. So I was looking at this to see if we couldn't make something work. And it ends up being, the ID on that is 1 inch, about 153 thousandths over 1 inch. Now that's kind of unfortunate, because the bore, the throttle bore, is right at 1 inch. So that would leave a lot, that would leave a lot of gasket hanging out there. So this may not work. This may not work for a cheap alternative. But if nothing else, you know, a guy can make his own intake out of a piece of 1 inch ID pipe and a couple of large flat washers. You know, just drill your gasket pattern out, bolt pattern, and your drill your port for your vacuum relief. Yeah, those come in a box that says YOFMOO. They all come in about the same box. I think, yeah, that's what the box this one came in. And the other one may have been, the one that said FULIN may have come in a plain box. I can't remember. But I had, my boys helped me move some of my junk generators over here from the old place. These have been stored in a barn for years. And I guess I need to clean them up. And we might do some work on some of these. I hate to just set them out and not do anything with them. And while they were there, they found that I'd had a couple of 420cc Predators in there, too, in the barn. So maybe we'll have to do something with those. I don't know. That's all I got for today. Thanks for hanging out with me. We'll see you next time.